Hey, welcome back to Lohre Farm, everybody. Got a little exciting thing to show you today. Well, I figured I'd take some time today to talk about my hay wagon that I turned into a vegetable cart, how I got it and how I built it and all those things. Let's see, I bought it fall of 2018, and I bought it from a guy who lives only a few miles north of us. It was in pretty rough shape, but he wasn't asking for a whole lot of money for it. So I figured a trip up there to talk to him was well worth my time. I think the first time I saw it, it had two flat tires. The main tongue of it was broken. But like I said, he wasn't asking a whole lot of money for it. So I thought, well, I can probably fix that up. So I ended up taking it back to the house, driving a couple of miles that I needed to drive at about 3 miles an hour since I said it had two flat tires. So I ended up getting it home and I tore the whole thing apart. I figured if I was gonna kind of rebuild it, I'd probably do it the right way, or at least best of the right way that I knew how to do it. The model is a 1947 International Harvester wagon. I tore it down to the nuts and bolts and basically started fresh from there. And I gave it the whole new paint job and made it look all pretty, and put a new deck on top of it. Then from there, I knew I wanted it to be for a vegetable cart or some kind of a vegetable wagon that we could put out by the driveway. And so I needed to figure out a roof. Well, when we had moved in here, there was a horse stable that the people who owned the property previous to us had, and I had all the roof off of that piled up along the side of the property. So I went and got that, painted some red and white stripes on it to give it a kind of a nifty look, and started building and putting the roof on. So far this year, it's basically housed the remainder of what remnants of our fence that we have left from last year when the fence got destroyed. So getting this all cleaned off of here now, and then the plan is to bring it up front and put it in its spot for the year. We're just starting to get some vegetables going, so that's pretty exciting. So this has been something I've been looking forward to.
getting the farm stand set up here. So first of all, we gotta clean off our holders. Here on the farm, this little guy is a Cayuga, and we got two of these, supposed to be female. We'll see how that turns out. They're great egg layers, and they're also meat birds. This is our blue Swedish. They have the yellow on the chest. Also a very beautiful bird, good egg layers. And these are fawn and white runners. They're good egg layers. They're a very small duck, not good for meat, but very good egg producers. And so we also got some khaki Campbells and some Gold Star hybrids. The Gold Star hybrids are very good meat birds. They're a good dual purpose bird. They're also dual purpose means good meat bird, also good egg layer. And then we have khaki Campbells, which are great egg layers also. So they'll be a great addition to the farm. Number one for the eggs for us. Number two, if we do decide to make them meat birds. And number three, just it's pretty fun to have new animals. So we're out today picking berries. One of the kids' favorite things to do. We have a ton of wild raspberries. As you can see, Van's filling his bowl. Makes for a great snack. Libby's got quite a few there too. We have a whole field of these. They're just everywhere. If we really wanted to, we could probably spend a few hours out here. However, we'll probably just spend 10, 15 minutes picking today. Like we have some visitors coming over to help us pick berries. Ducks are never far behind. Oh, very good find, Liv. What'd you find, bud? Oh, you found a whole bush. Watch out for the prickles, though. Very nice. Normally I suggest washing them before you eat them, but the kids just couldn't wait after their hard work harvesting. They just needed a little snack. Good work today, guys. Huh? We'll go back out tomorrow.